And we're at Eastman School of Music, Kilbourn Hall, with Gretchen Parlato. Gretchen, welcome to Rochester.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
And we're big fans of your music. We just love your style and your approach and how you can take either classic hip-hop songs or standards or create jazz standards in your own way. Talk about how you were able to do that with such ease.
Well, thank you, first of all. I think the approach is really that to treat each song as if the same way, as no matter what genre it is. So if I were to sing a jazz standard or something in the pop world or any other kind of cover, it's just a song. It's just a melody and harmony and structure, and anybody can, you know, breathe their life into it. So I just try to kind of simplify something, and then everything that I add to it is just my own, you know, personal honesty and something genuine. So if it reaches people and moves them and touches them, then I'm doing the right thing.
Speaking with Gretchen Parlato here on Jazz 90.1, songs like Juju or Weak from SWV or Butterfly from Herbie Hancock, just all those songs are just, we've heard them a bunch of times. Some folks haven't heard them, but when you do them, it just seems like they're brand new songs again. And we love that you're doing those things. Talk about your next project, because I've heard a lot about it and looks like it could be very, very surprising and awesome.
Oh, cool. There's actually a few things going on right now. We're going to put out a live album coming up that should be out by the end of the summer. And that's exciting because it's, you know, especially in the jazz world, actually in any kind of style of music, a live show, to hear an artist do their thing and kind of compare and, accompany a live performance compared with something that you hear in the studio is always fascinating to me. I always love hearing how an artist might transform or a song might grow and be moved into another space, you know, between the studio and the live album. So we thought we would put together a couple nights at a venue in New York City and, you know, capture some of that energy. Because these musicians they're a thrill for me to sing with, so I wanted to try to, you know, capture the magic that happens when we perform. And then I have Alan Hampton and I have been writing music together. So he's a bass player and a singer, guitarist who I've worked with for a long time. So we have a project kind of in the works. And then I'm doing a lot of things with a group called Tillery, which is Rebecca Martin and Becca Stevens and myself, and playing, you know, stringed instruments and writing original music. So there's a very different, you know, styles, but all very, very much from the heart.
Seems like the New York scene's a family again in terms of just people being helpful with each other, working on each other's projects. Talk about what's happening on the scene right now in the city.
Yeah, you know, I've felt very, very lucky, you know, since I moved to New York. It was 10 years ago already from LA. I know, it's crazy. And I feel like from the very beginning there was a sense of community and a group of people that really supported each other and challenged each other and inspired each other. It was always very, in a good way, really not even overwhelmed, but just completely challenged and inspired by everybody. And they all became my friends and collaborators. And I think there's not a sense of competition, I don't feel. You know, that exists, but I think it only exists if you play the game. You know, if you just choose to not be a part of it, then it doesn't exist. You know, so it's always felt really, really supportive.
Speaking with Gretchen Parlato, playing two shows tonight at Kilbourn Hall at 6 and 10. Gretchen, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you.